Hello everyone, my name is Steven. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about artificial intelligence research and why we should be optimistic about its advancement in the future. First of all, how many people here have used like digital assistants such as like Siri or Google Assistant? And probably everyone. They're in some way artificial intelligence because they interact with us and they help us do things. And can you guys imagine like what the world would be like when artificial intelligence like evolved further? That is the topic of artificial intelligence research. And there's some reasonable concern about artificial intelligence research, and in this presentation I'm gonna talk about some of those concerns and talk about how I think of it and why I'm still optimistic even though after seeing the picture. First of all, the picture on the left is the world reigning chess champion Garry Kasparov playing his chess game against IBM's Deep Blue artificial intelligence in 1996. And this marks a huge milestone for artificial intelligence because it's the first time that AI has beat us in some like beat the best human at something such as chess. And that brings us to the topic of intelligence quality. No matter how many like ants or chicken or like monkeys we bring together and then they think together, they will never be able to comprehend the complexity of human thoughts, right? And just like that, it applies to us too. One day when computers get like so much more intelligent than us that we'll never be able to comprehend what it's thinking. And just like the ants that couldn't comprehend what we're thinking, we wouldn't care so much if we step on an ant. Right? It may come a day when artificial intelligence is so advanced that they wouldn't really care to destroy us humans because they don't really care about us. And Elon Musk, for one, is one person that's really worried about this. So he thinks we should be really careful with artificial intelligence. But despite those concerns, the advancement of artificial intelligence research is also still really important because it could develop something that like we humans never could on our own. Some of the benefits include like personalized medicine because everyone's biology is different, and with artificial intelligence, it can treat people based on their fundamental biologies and make the treatment more effective. And it can also replace us in some of the mundane tasks that we don't really like to do, such as it can drive our car for us, it can fix our car for us, it can search the web for us, all sorts of things that right now, some are possible, some are not, but that's a no. And to address some of the concerns, historically, every time a new idea or a new technology has come up, people are always concerned about it because with new idea comes unknown and people don't really like unknown. Such as, for example, when the printing press was first introduced, people were worried that, it might bring too much data in the world, and then like people's brains not gonna handle all that much data. And the same with like just general education for the normal people. People are like somewhat worried that having school for children is gonna exhaust their brain, and like the multiple studies is gonna introduce like mental illness. And same thing with internet. People are worried that internet's gonna have a negative influence on people, and turns out it's like one of the best inventions ever. Okay. And there's also to note that like these changes, they don't happen instantly. And as time goes by, people are gonna get more used to the new ideas, and as problems come up, like engineers and scientists will seek to solve them as they come up. So there's not really that much to worry about, in my opinion. And so far we talked a little bit about like some of the concerns and how I think of like these issues, and hopefully should be seen as someone as an extension of us. And as like, it's interesting to think that as artificial intelligence keep beating us at our own game, like, you know, like chess, poker, Go, and a lot more, as it keeps beating us, it sheds away layers of what we think is what's fundamental or unique to us humans. And it allowed us to like gaze deeper into what it means to be human. And I close out with a quote from a book that I recently read. Trash has given us an appetite for art, and the inhuman has not only given us an appetite for the human,